X-59. NASA will test its groundbreaking quiet supersonic aircraft in the U.S. NASA will demonstrate its plans to test its quiet supersonic technology over United States communities this week in Nashville. The X-59, quiet supersonic technology, is an experimental jet that aims to reduce the amount of sonic boom produced by aircraft breaking the sound barrier. Supersonic flight, or flying at speeds greater than the speed of sound, is commonplace for military aircraft. But commercial airliners have been somewhat restricted over land due to the associated booms that come with this kind of flight, called sonic booms. These are a sequence of shock waves produced by supersonic aircraft that combine to form two deafening booms that can be heard for miles around. Overland, these booms make unacceptable noise levels for the public. While there have been some successes in the past, with the likes of the now long-retired Concorde, she was banned from conducting flights over land. Since then, on the whole, there have been few attempts to make the supersonic flight the norm for commercial airliners. But if means could be found to reduce the noise generated by these aircraft, especially over land, it could drastically shorten travel times. This is where aircraft like NASA's planned X-59 aircraft could prove revolutionary for air travel, fitted with something called quiet supersonic technology. This sonic boom reduction technology is being developed to make supersonic flight over land a real possibility in the future. NASA's X-59 quiet supersonic jet ready to fly. NASA's supersonic plane has moved closer to the runway in preparation for its debut flight. This milestone kicks off a series of ground tests to ensure the X-59 is safe and ready to fly as part of NASA's Quiet Supersonic Technology mission, which aims to demonstrate that the aircraft can fly faster than the speed of sound, or Mach 1, without generating the loud sonic booms generally produced by supersonic planes. NASA will then fly the X-59 over several communities to gather data on human responses to the sound generated during supersonic flight, officials said in the statement from the space agency. NASA will deliver that data set to U.S. and international regulators to possibly enable commercial supersonic flight over land. The X-59 supersonic jet is expected to produce only a gentle thump, or the equivalent of a nearby car door slamming, for people on the ground. In comparison, previous generations of supersonic aircraft are known to rattle windows when flying over the speed of sound. Therefore, the X-59 could lead to new sound-based rules regarding supersonic flight over land, opening new doors for faster commercial cargo and passenger air travel. The X-59 is powered by a single jet engine, which was built by General Electric Aviation, a subsidiary of General Electric. It is designed to reach a speed of Mach 1.4, or 925 miles per hour, flying at an altitude of 55,000 feet, 16,764 meters. The X-59 measures 94 feet, 29 meters, in length, and has a 29.5-foot wingspan, 9 meters. Like the Concorde, the aircraft has a long pointed nose cone that obstructs forward vision. This obstruction will be made up for by an improved flight vision system, which is most likely made up of 4K cameras. If all goes according to plan, the X-59 will fly over select U.S. cities starting in 2024. Residents will be able to share their responses to the sound produced by the X-59 aircraft. Then data collected from the flights will be shared with American and international regulators in 2027, when the Quiet Supersonic Technology mission comes to a close. NASA hopes to develop aircraft that would enable quieter supersonic flight, which could one day reduce domestic air travel times by half if approved. October 14, 1947, Chuck Yeager breaks the sound barrier. The first supersonic flight that took place in the Aerospace Valley at Muroc Air Force Base in 1947. Muroc Air Force Base later became known as Edwards Air Force Base. October 14, 1947, Chuck Yeager breaks the sound barrier. The first supersonic flight that took place in the Aerospace Valley at Muroc Air Force Base in 1947. Muroc Air Force Base later became known as Edwards Air Force Base.